With our widget builder, you can create smart pop-ups that are shown to visitors only as specified by a certain scenario. Make a personal offer at the right time. Help your client choose a product or service, or collect subscribers to interact with them using the SendPulse service. Let's talk about how to create a widget using a template and set up its appearance, message text, target action, and display condition. Go to your project in the Display Scripts tab and click Create Pop-up. For easier navigation, we have separated popular and holiday templates and divided them by type and purpose. There are the following types of pop-ups. The overlay type covers the entire site page. Users need to close the pop-up window to interact with your site page content. A floating pop-up is a window placed on the left or right of the browser window when a user scrolls the page. Users do not need to close it to interact with your site page content. A horizontal pop-up is a horizontal window that can be placed at the top or bottom of the page. Users do not need to close it to interact with your site page content. A video pop-up is a window that plays YouTube videos. If you select the automated scenario, the video will start playing after any user action on the page. If you select the Activate It When Clicked option, users will see the preview once the page is loaded, and the video will start playing when they click on the pop-up. On mobile devices, video pop-ups are always played only when users click on them. A modal window is a block located in the center of the page. All the other site page content is darkened and not clickable. Users need to close the modal window to interact with your site page content. According to the target action, templates are divided into cookie request. Ask site visitors for cookie consent. Your visitors can close the pop-up by clicking on the button or following the link to read your cookie policy. Call to action encourages visitors to take an action. For example, close the pop-up or go to your landing page. Social media subscription redirects your site visitors to the selected social network or messaging platform. You can add any number of social media buttons to one pop-up. If you have a chatbot, users will be able to subscribe to it and receive a welcome message. Chat interaction gives your site visitors to contact you via a social network or feedback form. Newsletter subscription collects your site visitors' email addresses. Phone number request collects your site visitors' phone numbers. Custom form collects additional subscriber data. Once you choose a template, you'll see the opened widget builder in the Content tab, where you can edit your widget appearance and change its target action. Choose whether you want to display an image or not. If you want to display an image, upload a JPEG, PNG, or GIF file that's up to 1 megabyte large, and align it with your text and button, left, right, top, or full screen. Select your background color, white, black, or colored, and the placement of your pop-up on the page. You can choose the placement only for floating pop-ups, video pop-ups, left or right, and horizontal pop-ups, bottom or top. If you selected the video pop-up type, add the link to your YouTube video and choose when to play it, automatically or after users click on it. Enter a context-appropriate message for your site visitors that will encourage them to interact with your pop-up. You can format your text and add links and emoji. Choose a target action. Each selected template has its target actions users are expected to perform. Click on a button, subscribe, or provide contact information. You can skip this setting or change your target action to remove or add fields and buttons. You can also save your contacts to the email and CRM services if you add an email or phone request to the form. Once you've set up your pop-up appearance and target action, click Next. There are 22 types of display conditions available. Show Always, the option set by default. UTM Medium, tracks the parameter that determines the type of traffic. UTM Content, tracks the parameter that determines the part of the page the user came from. UTM Term, tracks the parameter that determines the keyword or query phrase that led the user to your site from a search engine. UTM Campaign, tracks the parameter that determines the name of your advertising campaign. UTM Source, tracks the parameter that determines the traffic source where the user came from. Traffic Type, tracks where the visitor came from search engines, from social networks, entered the URL into the address bar. Time on current page. The widget will be displayed to your site visitor if they spend the specified amount of time on your page. Time on site. Tracks the time spent on all pages of your site. Number of sessions. The widget will be displayed to the user if the specified number of sessions takes place on your site. Scroll over 50% of the page. tracks how far the user scrolls the page. Cursor off-screen. The widget will be displayed to your site visitor if they start moving the cursor to switch to another tab or close the current one. Traffic source. Tracks the page the visitor came from. Current page URL. Tracks the page the user is currently viewing. You can choose this setting to show or hide the pop-up on certain pages of your site. URL of the visited site. Tracks the page the user came from. Page title. The widget will be displayed to the user when they visit your page with the same title. Browser. Tracks the browser and device your site visitor is using. Date period. The widget will be displayed only during the selected time. Pages visited. Tracks the total number of pages visited by the user. Pages visited in current session. Tracks the number of pages visited by the user during the current session. Browser language. Keeps track of the language set in the visitor's browser settings. You can choose this setting to show or hide the pop-up on different language versions of your site. Time period. You can configure the display of the widget on the site at certain hours, for example, during non-working hours. Select an event and a condition operator to track your site visitor's behavior and enter the value you want to track. If you want to add additional values to your current condition type, click the plus icon on the right. Select the AND or operator. The AND operator is used to strictly take into account each value, both the first and the second. If one of the conditions is not taken into account, then the pop-up will not be displayed on your site. The OR operator is used to take into account any of the values, the first or second. You can use different types of conditions and check the information using several parameters at once. If you want to add another condition, click Add Condition. Select the order in which the conditions are to be met. The ALL operator is used to display the pop-up only when all of the specified conditions are met. The ANY operator is used to display the pop-up when any of the specified conditions are met. Once you've set up all the necessary conditions, click Save and Publish. All of your pop-ups are displayed in the Display Scenarios tab. Once you create your pop-up, you can enable or disable it, view its appearance, edit any setting except for your pop-up type, and track statistics.